Hi, welcome to PiSignage. Today we're going to give you a quick overview of assets, and this will include the different types of files you can upload, how to create your own notice, how to upload a PDF, how to upload a website, and more. For today's video, we have this player that's currently connected to the TV. It's registered to our account, so it's all set to go. We also have a laptop here where I've signed into PiSignage.com and I have my account open in front of me. So with that being said, let's dive right in. So over here on the player dashboard, I have Demo TV, which is currently online and playing. This is the player that we had registered to our account. When we move over to assets, we see that there are no assets here. You can simply click on the add button to add any assets that you may want. It'll prompt you, allowing for multiple different types of uploads. I'm going to start with uploading a file. Before we upload our files, I'm just going to go over the different file types that we allow for. Uploading a file allows you to upload an image. This could be a PNG, a bitmap, a JPEG, or like in this case, a GIF. It also allows for any video format there is. Just bear in mind that any video that you upload onto PiSignage.com gets converted to an MP4 format. This is mainly so that it plays seamlessly on your player. But this shouldn't restrict you in what type of file you can upload. You can upload any video file you want. Just bear in mind that it'll get converted to an MP4. We also have a PDF over here with two pages. This is mainly going to cover on why I like cats. We also have a website here, which will dynamically update us on different cat facts so that we can keep updating the cat facts as this asset plays. Now, just to prepare this website, you could upload a single page HTML, or like in this case, when you have multiple files, you just want to select all of your files and compress them so that you get a zip file. So I'm going to compress these three, which will create archive.zip. I'm just going to name this to catsite.zip, and I'm going to move it to the main folder. So now we have all of our assets and they're ready for upload. So I'm going to go back to PiSignage.com and I'm going to select all of the assets that we had chosen and click on open. This should take a minute or two to upload. Now that the upload's complete, we have the option to select a category. Over here, I have a preset category called cat content, so I'm going to select that. You can also assign a validity. What a validity does is the minute an asset is past its validity period, it'll remove it from any playlist that it is referenced in. So for now, I'm going to add it from the beginning of this year up until the end of this year. And I'm going to click on continue. Now that we have all our assets uploaded, let's play them on our player. For this, I'm going to go to playlists, where I'm going to click on my first playlist. This is the playlist that we'll be adding all of our assets to, and I'm going to add all of our assets one by one. So I'm going to add the image, change its duration to 5 seconds. I'm going to add our website and change the duration of this to 10 seconds. I'm going to add our cat video. And over here, I have the option to mute audio, which I'm going to go ahead and do. We also have the option to add the PDF, where I'm going to select presentation mode. This is going to help us play all of the pages that were there on the PDF, and I can select an individual duration for all of the slides. So I'm going to select 5 seconds per slide so that it can play for the full 10 seconds. Now that we have our playlist completely ready, I'm going to go to groups, click on the default group where we have my first playlist set as the default playlist. I'm going to click on deploy. Now that we have our content over here, we can see our GIF playing, which should then switch to our cat site where all of the content keeps updating because it's a website. And right after our cat fact website, we have our video, which should play for a few seconds as well. And finally, it should end on our PDF, which is in presentation mode, so it should switch between all of the pages that are there. After this, it should just loop back around and start playing all of our content all over again. So this covers all of the ways that you can upload a file. From here, we're ready to move on to adding a link. So to add a link, we're going to go back to Assets. I'm going to click on Add and click on Add a Link. This should allow us to add a file name. So I'm going to say PiSignage Overview. We can determine the type of link, and PiSignage allows for multiple different links, whether you want a live stream, whether you want to stream an audio, whether it's a web link or a web page. It allows for media RSS links as well, where you could pull in images and video content from the RSS link. And for our link address, I'm going to go to youtube.com/PiSignage. And over here, I'm going to just select the overview video that we have. And I'm going to add that as our link address. I'm going to click on save. And you can now see that we have PiSignageOverview.tv, which is the web link that we just added. So now that we have our web link ready, I'm just going to go back to our playlist, click on my first playlist. I'm going to remove all of the other content that we had added and only select PiSignageOverview.tv. And over here, once again, I'm going to mute audio just so that it doesn't interrupt the video that we're trying to take today. I can update the video seconds to whatever I want. So I'm going to say 100 seconds. And from there, we're going to go back to our group, the default group where we have my first playlist, and click on deploy. This should now update what is playing on screen, and it should play our video straight from YouTube. And just like that, we have the video playing. So now that we have our video playing, we're ready to move on to the next two asset types, which is adding a message or creating a notice. So for that, I'm going to go back to our assets. I'm going to click on add, and I'm going to first add a message where I will say general notice. You could add optional CSS. For example, we're going to add a color, and we're going to change the color to black. Along with this, I'm going to just add a font size, and I'm going to change it to 64 pixels. With that being said, I'm going to add a message which says, can Derek please report to the front desk immediately. I'm going to click on save, which should soon add the asset over here as generalNotice.txt. Now that we have our message, I'm just going to also create a notice. Do bear in mind that we do have a default notice template, but using the template creator tool, you could add your own template for the notices. So with that being said, we're going to create this notice like we have a big conference event happening at our front lobby. So I'm going to just say big conference update, and for the body, I'm going to say, please proceed to the conference hall. And for the footer, I'm just going to say, for any questions, reach out to the front desk. We can also add an image. So I'm just going to add this picture that I had saved earlier, and that is going to be uploaded right into our assets folder, where it will be reused by this notice. And with that, I'm going to click on save, and it's going to show up in our assets folder. And over here, we see picture for notice, which is the picture used in the notice, along with the big conference update.html, which is the notice itself. Before I continue, I do want to take the example that we had in the notice to point out something very important. Any asset that is referenced anywhere in PiSignage, whether it's a custom logo, whether it is an image for a notice or an image for a playlist, they all are stored in assets. So if you upload any asset for the purpose of branding, or whether you're using it in notice or any other special asset type, just do bear in mind that it will be in assets and that's the place to find it. With that being said, we do have our message and notice ready, so we are ready to deploy the same. So I'm going to go back to my playlist and I'm going to deselect the link that we had chosen and instead select the big conference notice along with the general notice text, go back to our groups and click on deploy. Now that our screen's updated, we should see the notice with all of our information, the title, the body of text and the footer, and this should be followed by our message that we had. With that, we're ready to move on to our final asset type. This is a fairly simple one where you can add a local folder slash file. This only works with the Raspberry Pi version of our players, where you could store a local file or folder within the Raspberry Pi, or you could use a network file storage system which works over the local network. With that, you simply have to enter a file name, choose the type and add the link address. This is the location within the Raspberry Pi where the asset is stored. And once you click on save, that asset will continue to refer to the local asset that may be in any of the Raspberry Pis. With that, we do cover all of the asset types that you can upload. Before we end the video, just a few quick pointers to keep in mind. When you upload an asset onto PiSignage.com, there is a 3GB limit that you do have to bear in mind. You can upload any video you want, but it will be converted to an MP4 format. If you have a web page that isn't working or is causing a few issues, try toggling between the types web link and web page, and hopefully one of them should work for you. Add a local file or repository is a great option for businesses that are transitioning from, say, an analog method like USB sticks or network file sharing systems to a more cloud-based solution like PiSignage. With that being said, we do come to the end of the video. I do hope that this was helpful. And as always, if you have any questions, please write to support@PiSignage.com. With that, thank you so much for watching. And see you next time.